So we said accounting is the system where we measure, process, and communicate financial information for our company. And so we looked at transactions and how they change the accounting equation, and we made that worksheet. And in the worksheet, for every transaction, we would put the amounts in the column for the things that changed, and then we would compute balances. So that was how we were measuring and processing the financial information. And when we got to the end of the period, we could see all of the ending balances in each asset, each liability, and each stockholder's equity. And that information, that ending, those ending balances are what we are going to communicate to the users of our financial information, primarily our investors and our creditors. And we communicate that in the form of financial statements. And there's four main financial statements: the income statement, retained earnings statement, balance sheet, and statement of cash flows. We're going to be learning how to prepare the income statement, retained earnings statement, and the balance sheet in this chapter, and this is what we are going to be focusing on throughout the course. At the end of the course, we're going to learn how to prepare the statement of cash flows. We're just not ready to talk about this one now because we have a lot more complex things to learn before we can complete the statement of cash flows. Okay. So when we do a financial statement, we're going to have a heading. The first line of the heading is going to give the name of the company. Second line of the heading gives the name of the financial statement. The third line is going to be either a time period or a date. When we do the income statement and the statement of retained earnings, those are going to be for a period of time, from here to here, for the month or for the year. Okay. The balance sheet is only going to be as of the last day of the accounting period, so that will only be a date. So we're going to start off with the income statement because we're going to see we have to do our financial statements in order. And so the first thing you do is you prepare the income statement. You start off with that heading. And the income statement is going to show the profit of the company, right? Accountants call profit net income. Okay. So we start off with the revenue. Then we show the expenses, and we're going to list all of the expenses and come to the total of all of our expenses. And then we subtract revenue minus expenses, and that gives us our net income. So I want to take a look at an example of how to prepare an income statement. So here are all the balances, all of our assets, liabilities, and stockholders' equity accounts, right? So this would be the bottom line on the worksheet. So this is where our balances were at the end of the period. And we're going to use this information to do our financial statements. So the first financial statement we prepare is the income statement. And so we start off and we have our heading first on our income statement. So we put the name of the company. This company is named Platt Inc. And then we have the name of the financial statement, income statement. And then we have a period of time. This is going to be for the month ended November 30th, 2020. Okay. And so just for presentation in Excel, I want to make this centered across the columns where I'm going to show the names of the accounts and the amounts in these two columns. So I want to merge and center A, B, and C. So I'm going to click in the middle of A and stay clicked and then drag across B and C. And then I want to choose on the home menu, I want to choose merge and center. And that makes it one big cell and it shows up in the middle. I do the same thing. Click on A, drag it across to B and C, merge and center. And then the last one, I think this one is already centered, but we'll do it one more time. So there's the heading for my income statement. Next, now I want to get started, and the first thing I want to show on my income statement is revenue. And so the revenue, if we come and look at our balances, we have service revenue of $32,000. So that's what we're going to show first. Then we show our expenses. If we look at all of our account names, we can see we've got rent expense, We've got salaries expense. And what else? Oh, insurance expense. So we're going to list all of those. Then we get our total expenses. And just to show you in Excel, again, how to add. So you could do equal, click, plus, click. Okay, so you could do it that way. What I like to do though is I like to use this auto sum. If you click on auto sum, and then it's going to box whatever's above it, but that's not what I want to add. What I want to add is these numbers here. So if I click on the 20,000, stay click, and drag all the way down, I box the things that I want to add. And there's our total expenses. Then I want to show my net income. The 32,000 minus the 29,200 gives me my net income. And that's my income statement. Now, if you want to have the commas, like sometimes I'll see students in class are typing in the commas, you don't need to do that. You can format it. So I want everything to show commas, right? So up here where it says number, I click on comma, okay, and it's showing like this the numbers because the columns aren't big enough. And actually, the column will be big enough. I don't want to show the pennies. So if I come up here where the zeros are pointing and the arrow is pointing to the left, that's the increase the decimal. I want to decrease the decimal. So here, this is the what you click on to decrease the decimal. So I click it twice, and now the decimal places are gone. Okay. When the column shows up with all those numbers, it means it's too small. You can also adjust the columns by going in between the B and the C column, right? So you can see my cursor's a bubble. When I go in between the B and the C, it becomes a solid plus sign. If you click, and then you can drag it and make the column bigger or smaller. So that's just a couple of Excel tricks. But there's our income statement. So that's our first financial statement that we want to prepare. So we get our income statement, and hopefully we're going to have net income. We're going to have a profit. That means that our revenue was more than our expenses. And so when we have net income, that's going to increase our stockholders' equity. It's going to increase our retained earnings. If we have a net loss, so that's a negative net income because our expenses were more than our revenue, that's going to be subtracted from our stockholders' equity. So our next statement is our statement of retained earnings. And the statement of retained earnings is going to show how retained earnings changed during the period. And so we said that there's three things that change retained earnings: revenue, expenses, and dividends. Well, your revenue and expenses were combined in the income statement, and that resulted in your net income. So if we take our beginning retained earnings, we can add the net income from the income statement, come to a subtotal, and then we subtract the dividends because dividends makes retained earnings go down. And that's how we get to our retained earnings at the end of the period. So let's take a look at that in our example. So again, our statement of retained earnings is for a period of time. How did retained earnings change to the during the period? So how did it go from here to here? So how did it change during the period? Well, we start at with our retained earnings from last period, right? Our retained earnings from last period became our beginning retained earnings for this period. And so we want to take our retained earnings from last period and work our way down to the retained earnings for the end of this period. So, retained earnings at October 31st, 2020. If we go look at our information, so here we can see our retained earnings was 109,200. So that's our starting point. So the first thing that changed retained earnings is it went up by our net income. So if we go look on our income statement, we can see our net income is 2,800. So our retained earnings increased by 2,800. So if we add our beginning retained earnings and our net income, we get our subtotal of 112,000. So just to remind you how you do that in Excel, equal, Click on the beginning retained earnings plus click on the net income. And so then the other thing that changed retained earnings was dividends. We need to subtract our dividends. So if we go look at our balances, so this would have been the bottom line in our worksheet, our dividends are 16,000. So we're going to subtract the 112,000 subtotal minus the 16,000 in dividends. And that gives us our retained earnings at the end of the period, November 30th, of 96,000. So that's what the statement of retained earnings should look like. So in our example, we had ending retained earnings from last period. If it's your first period of operations, your beginning balance is going to be zero because when we started, we didn't have anything. So in the very first period of operations, you'll start off with zero as your beginning balance in retained earnings. But after the first period of operations, you'll always go to the last period's ending retained earnings. That became this period's beginning retained earnings. Okay, so the last thing we want to do is show the balance sheet. And the balance sheet shows that your accounting equation balances. So all you're doing is you're listing the assets, coming to the total, listing your liabilities, showing the total liabilities. Under stockholders' equity, you have common stock and your ending retained earnings. That's going to come from your statement of retained earnings. You get your total stockholders' equity, and then to show that you balance, you add your liabilities and your stockholders' equity, and this amount needs to be the same as your total assets. All right, so on the balance sheet, we're just showing what our balances are at the end of the period, so the last day of the period. So we're not going to have a time period. We're going to have a date on the third line of the heading. And the first thing we're going to show are the assets. And if we look, we can see the things that we have: accounts receivable, cash, what else do we have? Land, prepaid insurance, supplies, building. So all of these are going to be listed under assets. So we list out all of our assets, and then we show our total assets by adding them up. Okay, and I like to use that auto sum to add them all up. So we've got our total assets. Next, we show our liabilities. And if we look at our balances, our liabilities, we know if we see the word payable, that means we owe. So here we've got accounts payable, that's a liability. And then we've also got notes payable as a liability. And so we list those, and then we add them together to get our total liabilities. The accounts payable plus the notes payable. Next, we can do stockholders' equity. And under stockholders' equity, we've got common stock and retained earnings. And we can see in our balances, common stock had an ending balance of 40,000. Retained earnings is showing 109,200, but that's because it has not been changed for the net income and the dividends. We need to get our retained earnings by going to the statement of retained earnings. When we look on the statement of retained earnings, we can see that 109,200 was the beginning retained earnings. It was increased by net income, decreased by dividends. On November 30th, our retained earnings is 96,000. That's what needs to go on the balance sheet at November 30th. So that's what we want to show for retained earnings. Then we can add together the common stock and that ending retained earnings to get our total stockholders' equity. The last thing we do is we add together the liabilities and the stockholders' equity because we know our accounting equation, assets equal liabilities plus stockholders' equity. When we add liabilities plus stockholders' equity, that comes to 148,200. And that is the same as our total assets. And again, we can format this to get our comma in there to make it look nicer, and then decrease the decimal places, right? And so this is what our balance sheet should look like. So that's how we do our financial statements.